With Christmas fast approaching, it was time to leave the Black Point settlement and head to Georgetown, Great Exuma Island. As we motored out the cut into the Atlantic Ocean, we were greeted by a mild wind and gentle swell that made for a gorgeous day on the water. We were sailing along a steep drop-off on the ocean bottom, so we decided to toss out a fishing line and try to catch dinner.
Oh, that's edible.
That's a
nice
edible guy. Yeah.
Let me see. Yeah. Dinner.
Yeah.
Yay. Nice job.
It was a skipjack tuna, which are quite nice to eat. We were able to get two dinners from this guy, nothing like fresh fish on the grill. Later on that afternoon, we entered Exuma Sound, where we would spend Christmas and hang out for the next 6 weeks, prior to heading out onto what is known as the Thorny Path. We're looking forward to just relaxing and exploring the island. Georgetown will be much different than the other islands we visited, as it is a winter destination for a lot of cruisers, with a range of organized functions such as beach volleyball, water aerobics, beach yoga, polka nights, pig roasts, and the like. It's kind of like a floating RV park, or as others call it, adult daycare. Prior to leaving the U.S., Darcy stored her Christmas decorations on Kindred Spirit. The decorations added a festive mood to the boat, and we were able to continue some Christmas traditions as Christmas approached.
What are you making, baby?
Christmas cookies,
because it's Christmas time.
It's Christmas time. And I have really big trays. I kind of feel like I'm a kid with my little kitty tray. But the other one's a little bit larger. So I can make between 6 and 9 at a time. Might be doing this for a while. But they're so good and they taste like Christmas.
They do.
Now another time, then Butter Richies are going to come too.
All right.
Got to do both. And we bought a turkey.
Yeah, we did.
Turkey breast for our potluck Christmas on the beach. It's gonna be fun. How's that?
All right. That's it, girl.
So good.
It was a different kind of Christmas for Darcy and I, being away from friends and family. But in the end, it was memorable for us, and we enjoyed the fellowship with our cruising neighbors. Our days were spent exploring the islands, as there were numerous trails we could hike.
Is there a painted coconut? Aww. To mark the trail. Too cute. Oh, another one. That's why it's called the Art Trail.
Yeah.
Too cute. Yep.
Too cool.
It is.
Georgetown is one of the larger settlements in the Bahama Out Islands, which offered a range of resources for us, such as garbage disposal, grocery shopping, and local hangouts. Their public library was a source of novels for Darcy in their book exchange section. It was over 25 years ago that I was last in Georgetown. We went to a long-standing boutique resort called Peace and Plenty, where we ran into an old bartender from that time, Lemon. It was great to see him and enjoy his dynamic personality again. He's been working here for 50 years now.
Not
While in town one day, we walked out on the wharf where the local fishermen were cleaning their catch of the day. One was a conch fisherman who was cleaning the meat from the shells, and the other was cleaning his fresh-caught grouper. It was quite a show as the scraps were tossed overboard and devoured by five black-tipped sharks picking up an easy meal. With the onset of winter in the U.S., the fronts coming off the mainland make their way to the Bahamas. We had one fast approaching us, and it was time to batten down the hatches. This one was particularly nasty when it passed through the northern Bahamas, but it began to stall out as it went through our area. Nonetheless, it still packed a wall.
Oh, John, you can't even see those boats.
I know, right. That's only 22 knots. Not too bad. There's 26. You can't see shore anymore. And now it's really ripping.
Look back there, it's the side where
you're going. Look at that big motor yacht in front of us just about disappeared. Let me see what it's blowing here, dude. And then it was over. I'm sure this is just the first of a couple that'll probably come through this afternoon.
Scattered squalls.
Yeah, scattered squalls, exactly. There's a cold front, strong cold front that's going to be moving through. This is in front of that. So, yeah, we're anticipating and getting forecasts on stronger winds this afternoon. Through tonight, although as the night goes on, it should moderate. So a little bit uncomfortable, but hey, that's what living in paradise is all about.
While these fronts can put a damper on the day or days, it gives us some time to work on our bread making skills. We no longer buy bread in the market, as homemade bread is so much better. We've even begun to make our own flatbread, as packaged snacks are so expensive in the market. Darcy also learned how to basket weave from a friend on the beach. This is her first project, and she continues to make fun, functional baskets that we use every day. After Christmas, the weather conditions could still be problematic. However, there were days or weeks where the weather was just spectacular, which allowed us to get out in the dinghy and do some beach combing. Old friends of Darcy's also visited us during this time. It was great to see them. Bob and Terry stayed at a local resort. However, they were able to enjoy a number of nights on the boat. It was good hanging out with them, and it was hard to see them go. We toyed with the idea of buying a drone, as we thought the video we could capture would make the purchase worthwhile. We took the plunge and bought one prior to leaving the U.S. We finally had a couple of days of light winds that allowed us to begin flying it and capture some video. We are still low on the learning curve, but excited about how the early videos we have been able to capture. Christmas over and visits complete, it was time to start looking for weather windows to take us further east and south, down the proverbial thorny path on our way to the Caribbean.